been a long time in coming, but through the work of many, as you've heard from the previous speakers, partnerships, true partnerships, can make things happen.
And I think the changes that they have seen in the Beaufort Delta are incredible. And sometimes it's hard to imagine all of those changes that may have happened in the last 42 years, all the people that have come and gone.
But when I think about what we have here in Canada, we are truly blessed.
Delta, it's a real honor to have such a facility. We will be providing a very important service to our communities.
A project such as this requires the participation and support of a large number of individuals.
This is a happy, very good news event for me, so as minister.
I want to thank the many individuals who gave so much time and energy to get this project off the drawing boards in order to improve the health and well-being of the people of the Beaufort Delta region.
I'm really pleased that I was asked to reflect on the history of the health of our people in this region.
And a lot of credit has to go to the staff.
Welcome to Swongan. I'm your host, Janine Blake. On last week's program, we brought you the grand opening of Inuvik's new hospital. So on this week's program, we'll take you on a tour. We'll visit with some of the departments, but first we'll visit with Victoria Phillips, the coordinator for the Telehealth Center.
Telehealth Department is one of several sites in the territories that has the telehealth equipment that you can see here available for the people in the community and available for staff for educational and training purposes as well. We have several sites in the territories. There's Yellowknife, Hay River, Fort Simpson, Fort Smith, Inuvik, Holman, and Delany that presently all have this equipment, with the expectation that we will be expanding gradually in the future to more communities. Our system is for communication purposes, to keep in touch with other health facilities, doctors, specialists in the southern sites. And a lot of our remote sites will contact to Inuvik, and then we can make informed decisions here as to whether we can help them or whether we need to go to farther southern sites into Yellowknife, Edmonton, or Calgary. What our system consists of is basically a television screen. There's a VCR. We have a computer, which is actually right at the very bottom, and the monitor is what you see up here at the top. We have our keyboard and our mouse. On the side, this is an overhead projector like you would probably see in a school, but it also, on the bottom, has a light box for x-rays, which can be illuminated as well. The one here at the top is our main camera, which is what's showing the image on the screen at the moment. We can adjust that and move it to focus in or out or any direction we need it to go. As well, we have a patient camera, which is attached here with the cords to the equipment, but is nice and mobile for us to be able to use. If our specialist at the other end needs a close-up view of possibly an incision that's healing and he needs to see how it's healing, then I can zoom in closer, I can move around and be mobile to reach to the far side of the patient, whatever's needed. If possibly there's a young child that has problems with their ankles and walking, and he needs to see how they're walking, then again, this camera will come in handy for me to be able to record them walking across the room, and he would see it live over the television at his end. Coming into a telehealth visit is the same as coming to an actual doctor's appointment. It's confidential, and you are speaking to the doctor directly, asking him questions, telling him your situation, and he responds to you just as you would in a regular visit, except he's on the television. Once you get past being camera shy, you've got it made. We have a microphone that we use during our sessions, so this is how the doctor can hear you, or during education sessions, you'll be able to ask questions to the remote site, and this is how we would communicate. This item here might look a little scary to some, but it's actually very simple. This is the same as when you go to the doctor and you want to have your ears checked. This is what they would use. The difference being is the tubes that we have attached. This large one on the bottom actually is just a light that shines up in through the equipment, and the one on this end actually has a very tiny microchip inside, which is actually a camera, so that it shines through the tip, and when we place it in the person's ear, it will allow us to put the image directly onto the TV screen, which you will see full view of the child's ear or the person's ear, and the specialist at the other end will be able to view that while we're doing it. If it's an orthopedic clinic and we need to take a look at someone's bones, or a person comes in through eMERGE and they have a questionable break or a dislocation, the doctors may ask us to send an x-ray down to Yellowknife and have the radiologist look at them and get back to them to give them a diagnosis or a response as to what they feel should be done. So we would put the x-rays on our scanner. This does move. It would scan the image, sending the image into our computer and transferring it through telehealth down to Yellowknife, in which case the specialist would go to the same equipment that Yellowknife has, pull that same x-ray, and be able to have a look at that x-ray and make his decision, call our doctors back here, and get the patient the desired help that they need. So it's a quicker procedure. It saves money. We don't need to fly people out as often. It means people don't have to miss a lot of time from work or away from their families, and we'll be able to get the same medical care and assistance here in a shorter period of time. Education-wise, we do training and we have staff in services and workshops for our staff coming from many sites, Calgary, Edmonton, Saskatchewan, Ontario. We look for the appropriate workshops and services that we think will benefit our staff here, and we do offer them to our staff on a regular basis. They're able to attend these workshops here within the hospital without having to leave and miss work or their families once again, which again is a very large money saver, and they're able to attend more sessions this way than they would be able to if they had to ask for funding, I'm sure. Other than that, I think that's a brief overview of what we can do. The only other thing I can tell you is that this equipment is mobile and we can move it to different locations within the hospital. And it's been a very great benefit, I think, to everyone involved.
So we will return after these messages for more on our grand tour of Inuvik's new hospital. So stay tuned to APTN, the Aboriginal People's Television Network.
The building is broken up into different zones and sections, departments as such. We'll kind of go into each of them. We have people stationed in each of them who know their areas best and can talk about what goes on in those and how the areas function. And we'll cover the whole building, top to bottom, go through the whole area.
What you're looking at now is the office of the Diagnostic Imaging Department, and Amanda's our receptionist. So she's been with us for about 3 years. And when you come, Amanda's the first person you see when you come to the Diagnostic Imaging Department. And whether you're coming for an x-ray or an ultrasound or a mammogram, then this you come to the same place. And you just come through the hospital clinic or from the emergency department to here. And Amanda takes your information, makes sure that your requisition's correct. And then she does your paperwork. She looks up your old files to make sure that we have your records correct. And then she'll let one of us know. There's two technologists in the department. She'll let one of us know that you're here. So she brings the paperwork down the hall, and then we see what your form is. We get ready to do your exam.
Where we are right now, it's one of the main corridors through the area. It takes, kind of separates the acute care side and our clinical side. It's kind of the heart of the organization in the center of the building. And one of the concepts we employed as we worked through the design was trying to bring as much light as possible into the building. So what we did in raising here is coming up brought a bank of windows called a clear story through here. So it brings the natural light right into the center of the building. And it's one of the things, as we work through it, we really worked hard to try and bring as much natural light into the building and into the areas where people are, where either clients are resident patients, into patients' rooms, or into spaces where people are working on a continuous basis. And throughout the process, we actually measured how much of it we were doing. Initial designs, we started out, there was approximately 55% of people had access to natural daylight. And I think we ended somewhere around in the high 80s. So we really brought, it was really one of the focus of the designs. And as you can see by the light streaming in, it's certainly bright, it's certainly a bright, airy, open building.
The GP clinics are on this side. If they have a general appointment with a doctor, if they have special clinics, they go on this side. The receptionists are sitting there and they do both. They can do both. If you have a special clinics or if you have general clinic. For special clinic, secretary is Jane Talici. For a registration clerk, it's Maureen Gowans, myself. Appointments is Joan Gordon and Jackie Stephenson. Special clinics supervisor and overall supervisor is Pat Patrick. When they come to the hospital, it's nice to bring their health care card. Very important. The other thing is if they have a lab rec, x-ray, radiology, they should bring their form in order to let us know where they're going, and for the purpose of the lab team, Rick. We only use the yellow forms for radiology, laboratory, occupational therapy, physiotherapy, and nutritionist. And now we have a new added one, the diabetic clinic.
The laboratory. We only do tests when ordered by physician, so the physician will send the patient either to our window where we'll bring them into our phlebotomy room to draw samples, or we'll go to emergent outpatients to collect on patients who are not mobile. We vary tests here from complete blood counts, which help determine hemoglobins or coagulation tests for people who are on blood thinners. And other tests, such as microbiology at the time, we send down to Edmonton, or other tests we send to Yellowknife, such as our cholesterol testing, because we don't have what's necessary to do the testing here. With the increased efficiency of the lab, the layout of the hospital, we're hoping to be able to bring back some of that testing here. Speaking of layout, that's one of the big things from advantage of moving to this hospital is the way the lab is laid out. Everything's in one room now. We used to have it in two rooms, so it caused a lot more legwork and decreased efficiency. Now with everything in the one big open space, it makes it easier to get to where you need to be. Also, the layout between the lab and the emergency department and the acute care. In the old hospital, the acute care used to be on the ward 200, and again, just caused a little bit more time when the doctor wanted some specimens or some testing to get to the patient and get back to the lab. My favorite part would probably be the layout of it, just because everything seems to be fit to work better. Everything to increase patient access and efficiency.
So welcome to the new Inuvik Regional Hospital. This is the transportation department. I'll tell you a little bit about the responsibilities that this department has. We look after the general public's travel, for the Inuvik region. And we may have clients come into the Inuvik Hospital for treatment or travel south, which may be Yellowknife, Hay River, Edmonton. And this department is responsible for booking all the travel for patients as well as escorts. We handle medevacs for the Inuvik region out of this department during normal business hours. Of course, our emergency department handles medevacs that are required after normal business hours. We also look after Inuvik Health Board employees and their dependents, staff medical travel, staff duty travel, and we take care of arranging physicians travel in and out of the communities within the entire region. And we are responsible for looking after the Inuvik Regional Health Authority's vehicles in Inuvik as well as all of the communities. So it's quite a busy department. We have a staff of five.
Included in the staff is a handy van duty driver who is, of course, based in Inuvik and handles transporting disabled clients back and forth to appointments or out within the community. He's involved in taking long-term care clients on social drives, and we also deliver the Meals on Wheels within the town of Inuvik. So it is a very busy department. We're happy to be in the new building, and we're centrally located, which is very convenient, especially for transient center staff. People coming from outside the community are directly upstairs from us, so it's very convenient for us to be right here. They've all acknowledged that since the new hospital has opened. So my staff are, Chris Bala is the client travel specialist. Chris has been with us quite a few years now. Esmeralda Harassi is also a client travel specialist. Megan Gordon, from here in Inuvik, looks after the Inuvik arrivals, staff medical travel, and also booking the physicians to the communities. Moses Gordon is the handy van driver at present. The handy van driver full-time is Brad Firth, but he's on leave until October. So Moses is with us until October.
What you're looking at right now is one of the new standard single unit rooms in our acute care section. Virtually everything in this room is newly furnished. Each single room has its own self-contained washroom, no sharing of facilities, sink there, nice comfortable chair for visitors, television system hooked in with cable and everything, so very comfortable. All patient rooms have access to outside windows, are all on exterior walls. Service things are kept on the internal side, so patients have viewed natural light and can look out the windows, and very, very comfortable, functional, lots of room for the staff to move around, and very nice, as you see, the color theme maintained throughout, very bright and comfortable.
Swangan will return after these messages for more on our grand tour of Inuvik's new hospital. So stay tuned to APTN, the Aboriginal People's Television Network. Back with more of our grand tour of Inuvik's new hospital. In this segment, we'll bring you to the trauma unit.
The major trauma room. When you come to the emergency department, if you're not doing too bad, you can come up to the desk, give us your name, and usually we'll ask you if you have any allergies, get you into the trauma room. So this is the major trauma room. You may come in here even though you're not a major trauma patient, but like if you need a nebulizer, you might come in here. If there is a major trauma, then we'd scoot you out to another room and then let that patient come in. Nice thing that everybody really likes about this room, big change for us, is that we've got wall oxygen, wall air, and wall suction. Before, we had to carry around these big, or pat these big cylinders, and we trip over them, and not nice. So that's one nice thing. We've got a lot of new equipment. They've been really treating us well. And one of the pieces of new equipment is the crash cart. So it was more than just an actual move from the old hospital to the new hospital. There was a lot of thinking going into a huge amount of preparation. And for us as nurses, that means that there was streamlining of supplies. We've really tried to organize things so that we can easily find things. And you can really notice it, especially in this room. So this is the area that you would come in if you needed help after hours, or if it was an emergency, if you're really having troubles, you can always come through here 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. This area right here is where the ambulance comes through, so if an ambulance can come through there, or say you needed wheelchair access or something that you couldn't get through the doors, then you could always come in through there, we'll let you in. Security is standing right there, so they'll see you. This door is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, this outside door. This door will be closed. It's a sliding door. got the day surgery room down there. It's a beautiful room. It's got sunrise and sunset colors, kind of similar to that. And there's four stretchers in there. They're brand new stretchers. And again, it's the wall, air, suction, and oxygen. And then the ICUs here, it's a three-bed room now. It used to be a two-bed. And everything's in there. There's a crash cart in there, a defibrillator. And it's nice bedtime blue. And then there's the nursery. It's a little bit of an awkward spot for the nursery. But generally nowadays, moms are keeping their babies with them in their rooms, and the rooms are mostly single rooms. There's a couple double rooms. But so we really encourage moms, because babes are eating all the time, just about. And so we just keep the babes in the rooms with the moms. If we want to do a temperature, vital signs, or have a good look at the baby, then we'll bring it down to the nursery. But usually the baby's just going to go right back to mom.
We'd like to congratulate the board and staff of the Inuvik Regional Hospital for the seamless transition between the old building that served us well and the brand new beautiful hospital. That was our program for this week. Thank you for watching, Swanen. I'm your host, Janine Blake, and I'll see you next week.
Of the Royal Canadian Legion Ladies Auxiliary, it gives me great pleasure to present this big screen television to the residents of long-term care and the Inuvik Regional Hospital.
The members at Inuvik Detachment and our spouses planned a regimental ball, and it was going to be a charity ball with the proceeds going to the hospital, the new hospital. It was a lot of hard work by the members and spouses, and on behalf of the charity ball, Diana and I are thrilled to present a check for $5,000 to the green space as described by Dr. Uswak.
This is presented to the Inuvik Regional Hospital on behalf of the people of the Northwest Territories to commemorate the official opening by the Commissioner of the Northwest Territories. May God comfort each and every one of you, Monday, June 16, 2003.